things properly in order to have the invariance under finite dimensional perturbations, if you will, you need also to introduce a final topology such that you remain in a set of bounded operators. Otherwise, you wouldn't get that some certain multiplications are continuous. It's really, as I said, it's a bit more technical than that I in the way I presented it. But
I can imagine, yes.
But on the good part, you would get that you can characterize continuity with respect to this topology only using sequences and not referring to nets.
Okay, yeah.
Does this have any consequence for parabolic problems?
Well, you can you can directly apply all these results to parabolic problems. If you look into the standard formulation of parabolic problems that we do in this evolutionary equations case, it really boils down to just looking at continuous dependence on the coefficients of partial differential equations. And one can show in the parabolic case for bounded domains that this non-local age convergence I just introduced is continuous in the solution operators. So you can really, the solution operators, depending on those coefficients, are continuous with respect to the non-local age convergence with values even in the strong operator topology for the solution operators.
So for the case of periodic problems you were mentioning in your answer, this means that you can relate the solutions of the parabolic problem in a cell to the solution in the whole space?
You start off with a problem that is formulated only on omega, and those coefficients, they are depending on the period cell only. And this you truncate your problem onto already anyway. If you look into the whole space, you need different techniques, but you can also do that. And then you would with the Gelfand with some Gelfand transform, you would then transform the whole space problem to a problem on the periodic cell or on the quasi-periodic cell. And then you can apply the same results here.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks.
Do you have a presentation? Do you see it?
Well, yes. Yes, we can see it.
Why, it is a little bit later time?
Well, I think we have still 1 minute to go.
Hmm? to my mind.
At least on my...
According to my clothes, that is about 7 minutes later.
Ah, okay. So as far as I can see, the schedule, your talk starts at 9:50, and right now it's 9:50 at my clock.
Exactly, yes.
So, okay. So I think we can start now. So welcome, everybody. Let's welcome Irina Melnikova from Russia, who will present on operator semigroups associated with stochastic processes.
Mm-hmm. So the title is here, and I can continue. A wide class of processes arising in various fields of natural science, economics, and social phenomena now can be mathematically described by stochastic differential equations. Great interest in this problem of financial mathematics, especially maybe late 40 years after Black-Scholes formula rewarded Nobel Prizes, had led to significant advances in this area. Most study here is the class of diffusion equations with Wiener processes. And it is suitable for describing processes that do not have jumps. Simulation based on Levy and more general Levy type process allows to study along with continuous jump processes. At the same time, both in applications and in fundamental science, often what we needed is not really the random process itself, but probability characteristic, different probability characteristic. And it turns out that semigroup techniques allowed to study many important characteristic, and we will use semigroup techniques. Here we see table of contents. At the beginning, statement of the problem when operator sum operator semigroups related to basic really Levy processes, that is shift process, Wiener processes, and Poisson, simple and compound. Then it will be about properties of translation semigroups and via generators, that is really way these semigroups and generators are pseudo-differential operators. And in conclusion, transition semigroup will be shown within the framework of general semigroup and Gelfand-Shilov classifications. So semigroups under consideration are of the following form. Here, capital P is transition probability of homogeneous Markov process, and P small is transition density if it exists. That are transition or sometimes stochastic semigroups. And our goal, as it was mentioned already, to consider semigroups related to basic Levy processes, to show that generators are pseudo-differential operators and operators with kernels being distributions, to show the place of stochastic semigroups in the Gelfand-Shilov and general semigroup classification. The capital P, the function being transition probability, homogeneous in time Markov process, satisfies the equality, that is homogeneity in time, and Kolmogorov-Chapman equation, it follows semigroup property for the family of semigroups. And semigroup is Markov if for any f from the space of bounded function, there are following properties, but this semigroup equality here, property positivity preserving, that is Submarkian property and conservativity property. And among Markov processes with continuous and jump components, the most famous are Levy processes. By definition, a Levy process that is L, but stochastically continuous with independent stationary increments and zero at zero. In addition, Levy processes are spatially homogeneous and they have the Levy eta form, this one. That is, corresponds to continuous part, and this one corresponds to jump part. And we start by looking at semigroups related to basic Levy processes. At the beginning, we consider U1, that is shift semigroup, and we consider with on Rn with n equal to unity for clarity. And we can see from definition this shift semigroup, but here probability density exists, and that is generalized function shifted, delta function shifted to point x with the initial value plus bt. The semigroup is strongly continuous on C0, that is continuous and tends to zero at the infinity, and the semigroup is the solution to the Cauchy problem. Here, the generator A1, that is differential operator of first order. The second semigroup, that is well-known semigroup with normal density, or Brownian motion density, and the semigroup gives solution to the heat equation with this generator. And this semigroup is strongly continuous on L2 and on C0. The third one, we can see the semigroup related to Poisson process with jump values Q and intensity lambda. And here, due to the fact that we have transition probability, and we can here to write in transition probability in this form, we can find density, transition density with the sum of, again, shifted, but in space variable delta function, and so on. We have semigroup in such form with transition density. And by definition of the generator, we have this one. Generator here is not differential operator, but is difference operator. And respectively, U3 gives solution to Cauchy problems with difference generator. It is strongly continuous again on C0, that is special new situation, new equation in a sense. And with four semigroup, that is semigroup corresponding to compound Poisson process. Here, let ZK be independent, identically distributed random values with distribution law mu when Z defined as follows is a compound Poisson process. Property of this process we show due to characteristic function, this one. We can see that it's really direct or inverse Fourier transform. And that is very often used characteristic in this area. And for this process, that we proved that for characteristic function has holds the formula, the following formula. And this formula obtained has a lot of consequences, useful consequences. Using this characteristic function and using a famous Levy-Hinchin formula, again, in the case R, we, due to Levy-Hinchin formula, characteristic function of Levy processor has the form via symbol that is S of alpha, that corresponds to continuous processes and that to process, that one to process with jumps. And for L4 equal to Z to this one, to compound Poisson process, the integral terms due to the formula obtained is as follows, that this special part of this term integral and characteristic function for X4, that is here it is written form is as follows. And we show that generator of semigroups and more general semigroups corresponding to process of such type X initial value plus Levy process are pseudo-differential operators. But pseudo-differential operators, but this operators of the form with symbol S, with special properties from different class of pseudo-differential operators. And example underlying the definition of this operator really is a differential operator with variable coefficients and symbol is such. Hence, we can see that U1 and U2 semigroups are special cases with differential generator and they are pseudo-differential operator. Really, we have theorem for more general processes. Let LT be Levy process and U be semigroup related to shifted Levy process. When the generator of U is pseudo-differential operator and operator with kernel from this Schwarz space with distributional, really distributional kernel. For F from test function S, we have the formula and we have general form of such of generator for such semigroups, but again, pseudo-differential operator with this symbol. And using this general result, we can obtain a generator of U4. semigroup with this type of difference, really again type of difference operator, and of A3 with this really difference generator. And the second part of the theorem with operator generator operator with kernels with this due kernel Schwarz theorem, and we obtain really Q of K here for kernels, kernels really for generators one A1 and 4. And knowing symbol, no symbol of this in this example, we obtain kernels K1, K2, with this here, with this differential really operator, and for K3 and K4, that is more interesting operator. First, we know that the generators of semigroups under consideration are pseudo-differential operator, in particular differential and difference operator, where a generator to contraction semigroup, it was follows from definition of Markov semigroup in the space of bounded operator. And that is that follows Hille-Sidde estimate for the resolvent, this one. Moreover, due to very interesting relations between spectral characteristic resolvent, spectral characteristic and characteristic by symbol, this estimate, Hille-Sidde estimate, holds in L2 space. As we saw now, in examples, consider a transition semigroups give solution to different differential difference Cauchy problems, and in general, transition semigroups give solution to the abstract Cauchy problem with A being pseudo-differential operator. The estimates for the resolvent about which I just told allow to indicate place of this semigroup within the framework of semigroup classification in Banach spaces and in Gelf and Shilov classification for differential system. Semigroup, general semigroup classification is the classification of abstract Cauchy problems by the first well-posedness properties and by behavior of resolvent in Banach space that are strongly continuous, integrated, convoluted, and are all regularized semigroup. This classification are quite known for semigroup people, and so I will not dwell on it. We have different estimates for resolvent and worse and worse if to go by these semigroups. But as for Gelf and Shilov classification, it may be a set definition. The classification here is due to exponent of related to Fourier transform matrix A, and due to eigenvalues of this Fourier transform matrix. Due to behavior of this transform matrix, Fourier transform matrix and corresponding exponent in Gelfand-Shilov classification are highlighted Petrovsky correct system, conditionally correct system, and incorrect system. Now, you can see conditions for lambda, which gives corresponding type of systems, And so here, Gelfand-Shilov classification is due to behavior of lambda, that is lambda, that is maximum of eigenvalues transformed matrix transformed by Fourier matrix. Так. So, before I will show inclusion of translation semigroups to general semigroup classification, I would like to say a little bit about comparison scheme, which we have got some years ago. For a lot of time, it was seen that we can see that this general semigroup classification and Gelfand-Shilov classification are related because the first one, the estimates to resolvent and the estimates to exponent of Gelfand-Shilov have the same estimates. The second one, they have very similar spaces of generalized function via the corresponding equation or semigroups have some maybe in some part of classification. And at the beginning, we had hypothesis that the meta is as follows, that C, zero semigroups and integrated semigroups are related to Petrovsky correct correct system, convoluted semigroup are related to conditionally correct systems, and R semigroups related to incorrect systems. Due to some theorems and very interesting example constructed, turns out we showed that the meta is not so simple. And really, the relations between these objects are as follows. It is not so simple as we thought at the beginning. And having this comparison scheme, now I can show embedding of transition semigroups to the scheme. Really, transition semigroups may be embedded in this one, in semigroup classification without any bounded. The semigroup classification really is given for operator, very general operator, for example, pseudo-differential operator, and due to estimates for a solvent, which showed transition semigroups replace of transition semigroups are here, really, in general semigroup classification. And here on this scheme, we can see transition semigroup in intersection in this scheme, which relates semigroup classification and Gelfand-Shilov classification. Here, of course, all this is true just for differential system, not for general general PCD operators. So it's time for me, and with this main references which I can show to this talk. And thank you for your attention.
Yeah, thank you very much for this interesting talk. Are there any questions or comments from the audience? So I have one question concerning your comparison scheme. Do you always have examples? Which
one or previous one?
The comparison scheme, though, like this one, yeah. Do you have examples showing that these classes are actually strictly contained into each other in a way?
Here it is written that they intersect really. Yeah. But it's, we know that C semigroups that is inside integrated semigroup and integrated inside convoluted, and all these semigroups inside R semigroups. But here, when we begin to compare with Gelfand-Shilov classification, that is intersection, but is not embedded really.
Okay, thank you. Any further questions or comments? Okay, this does not seem to be the case. Then let's thank Irina again. And we will have our next and last talk of this session in 7 minutes.
Oh, I had a lot of time and worried it's not enough.
So there's always a five minute break between the talks. So okay, thank you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
So maybe I will try to show my presentation on screen if it works. Yes. Can you see it?
Yes, everything is fine.
So this is actually a notebook and I will make annotations on my presentation. Yeah. Then I will send the PDF. So it works, okay.
Yeah.
Let me do one more thing. Turn off the virtual background.